Thank you again for faithfully joining us.
We would love to lay hands on you personally, but you know what? The anointing of the Lord transcends space. And so rest assured that as the word is being delivered at this time, the Lord has the capacity to heal you, even if you're just watching us. So I just want to continue with cardiovascular diseases, you know, the risk factors. One study shows that if you have low vitamin D level, you're also prone to developing heart attack, ischemic heart disease, and heart failure. So it's really important to supplement ourselves with vitamin D. The recommendation is at least 2,000 international units per day. So make sure that when you go to Walgreens or your favorite store, that the vitamin D that you are supplementing yourself with is at least 2,000 international units. And also get out of the house, have some sunshine, enjoy the nice day, go for a walk. That way you get a free vitamin D, plus you are burning those extra calories while you're doing your walking and running. Also, one research showed that supplementing ourselves with vitamin C will actually protect our blood vessels from developing blood clots. They found that plaque formation inside our arteries only develop in areas where there are inflammation, because it exposes, when there is damage, it exposes lysine, which is a component of your collagen. And once your collagen is exposed in your blood vessel, then it attracts all those cells, the cytokines, you know, all those inflammatory cells, where they develop a possible plaque, you know, that, and that plaque can just get dislodged anytime and can cause heart attack or even stroke if it gets stuck in one of the arteries of the brain. So another thing is magnesium. The magnesium is very important. I know a lot of people that they don't supplement themselves with magnesium, and then they complain of irregular heartbeat. Remember that our heart it has an electrical component to it, and it needs magnesium so that the beating of the heart is lub-dub, not the lub-dub-dub-dub-dub, you know, it's irregular. That's the beat when you have atrial fibrillation. And we need calcium and magnesium to make sure that those cells, the electrical cells of the heart, don't get crazy and would fire just erratically. And one more thing is, just like what Dr. Susan said, I love it when he said that, keep a positive attitude, smile. Even when we're smiling like that, when you're watching us, our brain rewards us with dopamine. It's the happy hormone that takes care of stress and all our pain in our joints. So even if things are not happening right in your life, just smile, because something's happening in our brain that keeps us healthy. Also, they found out that people that are impatient, gets easily irritated, gets angry, hold on to grudges and hurts, you know, they have a higher level of C-reactive protein. And what is C-reactive protein? It's a marker of inflammation in our system. So can you imagine that if you have those kind of emotions, you have twice as much inflammation in your system. And what does it mean? If you have more inflammation in your arteries, then you are attracting again those blood clots that causes the heart attack. If you go visit your doctor, I really encourage that when you hit, I would say 30, because now they found out that there's an increasing incidence of heart attack, even with a 30 to 45 year old, that even once a year, go to your doctor and just do a blood draw and for them to check your blood sugar. Again, I want to say that if your fasting blood sugar is 126 milligrams per dl, then that's very diagnostic for diabetes. Also, if your hemoglobin A1c is more than 5.7, you are high risk for developing diabetes. And again, if you don't know why is my doctor testing me with hemoglobin A1c, it studies the past, the control of your blood sugar for in the last 3 months. Because if the blood sugar is just floating out there in your system, then they attach to the red blood cells. That's the reason why we're testing your hemoglobin A1C every 3 months. And check your vitamin D level. If research showed that vitamin D level predisposes you to heart problems, then check your vitamin D, your magnesium, and make sure you supplement yourself with those vitamins, because they are very essential to the functioning of our heart. Another one is stress. Life is short, and my goal for this year is to have eternity at the back of my mind all the time, 24/7, so that when I do stuff, I won't really be worried about it, because everything here on earth is temporary. Even the Lord said that your present and momentary trial are nothing. They can't even compare to the glory that will be revealed one day when we will eventually join Him in heaven. See, even if you're watching, like, just the thought of heaven, you feel like that woman is speaking there is weird, because nobody has really incorporated eternity in their mind, in their perspective. But if you are looking at things in a different way, that, you know what, yeah, the Bible says that we're gonna have trouble, the Bible says we're gonna have challenges, but then it also says that He who died on the cross has already overcame, He has overcome everything, and we can live a victorious life, you know, because we are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. So I realized that keeping in mind, at the back of my mind, those eternal perspective make things easier. I can laugh at my mistakes. I don't really care if nobody likes me at all. I don't have to please people, because the only person that I need to please is the Lord. So it makes your life easier, right? You're not gonna worry about people that doesn't like you, or people that are mad at you, because your goal is just to love on them. And I always go back to the biblical solutions. You know, if you have financial problem, there is a God that said He will provide for me, I don't have to worry. If the yoke or the load in my life is too heavy, I have a God that instructs me that you can unload those heavy yoke, and I will carry them for you, because my yoke is easy and my burden is light, and you can learn from me. See, when the Lord says in the Bible to keep your joy, keep your peace, I have given you your peace, we think this is just a theory, but these are the very stuff that affects our health. A lot of people, you know, develop cancer due to anger, a lot of cancer due to depression and anxiety. And to be honest, if we all goes back to lack of trust in the Word, or the Word is there, it's in the Bible, but we never really believe in those by heart. It's just there, I read it many times, but never really become part of me. So that's my goal for this year, to make the Word of God like my anchor. This is the one that stabilizes me. This is the thing that stabilizes my health. I may be struggling right now with, I don't know, osteoarthritis, hypertension, heart attack, cancer, but there's an amazing God that is more powerful than everything that I experience. So I just release healing over you right now. Like, you will get your healing. Make the Lord your number one, just like what He said, love the Lord with all of your heart, your mind, your soul, and your strength, and that all these things will be added unto you. Now, we can never get away from that promise from the Lord, that if we make Him number one, He said that all these things that you're asking of me, like your health, your finances, your restoration of your relationship problems, I will add them to you, because you made me the number one treasure of your life. So thank you. We love you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.